quality of graphics. And this had a like moral system that depending on what targets you shoot, you get moral points. Let's see, okay.
Start the operation. Release 5 sectors under Belkan control.
So we are taking the capital back. Capital of Ustio. So yellow ones are targets that aren't so moral to shoot. They are not noticing that you are not giving much of mercy. I'm trying to keep the golden path. So soldier rank is what I aim to get. Okay, that one is not leaving. AA gun next to the church. That's not allowed, according to the rules of war. Okay, that's not really a competent target, but we can still shoot it there. So much for the office buildings. Jamming blade somewhere. Okay, that's a EA. Okay, that's a crawler basically. Hornet, that has jamming equipment. I think my wingman got it. E10. There's a couple planes at my 6. Missiles don't really grow on trees in this game. Of course, you have enough missiles for more than in realistic plane would have. I don't need to shoot every yellow one. So basically, depending on your rank, you get different kind of adversaries in this game. So there's lots of player agency, basically, depending on your rank. Suhoi 37, okay, that's... Yeah, with the Gripen, okay. Why not? Okay, that was lucky hit.
Airspace threat eliminated. Galm team, mission complete. We've taken back this sector. Belkan is no longer in control.
Cipher, you hear those people screaming for freedom? That's where we come in. Directus is free of any threats now. Let's head back to base.
On May 13th, 1995, Ustio was finally liberated. The tide of war was about to change dramatically.
Belka's Ustio branch headquarters has fallen. Directus has been liberated. I just received a vintage bottle of Chateau Bouloise for the Galm team. It's a hard-to-find Cabernet. Perfect, I'd say, for celebrating an occasion such as this.
Okay, so I should shoot a bit more of those yellow targets. Trying to keep it in the middle here. first game playthrough was a night. So let's go.
The true nature of the war begins from this point forward. Accounts vary depending on the article and source. Everyone is a hero and a villain, and no one knows who is the victim and who is the aggressor. And what is peace? All questions commonly asked about any war in history. As the battlegrounds move to Belka,
Ilta.
He is also thrust into the middle of this war. This is also where my interests shift from the war.
8 minutes ago. I was in the middle of battle, so couldn't say hello. Ilta.
Intelligence reports that Belka is developing nuclear arms and V2, a weapon of mass destruction. The Allied forces' top brass have decided to send troops across the Hydrian line into Belka to check for nuclear arms and secure resource interests. Centered on the ruined base of Gladys, the Hydrian line, Belka's long line of defense, stretches 700 kilometers from Osea's southern border to the border of Sapphire. Situated at the peak of Mount Agrea, the ruins of Gladison have been transformed into a modern base with anti-aircraft artillery and a powerful defense system. The Galm Team's mission is to launch an aerial strike on Gladison, opening the door to Belka for our ground troops. In all probability, this will be an extended operation. You'll be able to refuel during the latter half of the mission. If you're low on fuel, temporarily withdraw from the battle and return to base. Good luck.
So, basically this is a grinding mission. Huge amount of ground targets. Suppose we are going to take Creepen and... So, different color schemes. Oh, this looks cool. Night color, okay. This is pretty cool as well. I like this color. And then we are going to take this is basically a cruise missile, so Getting some damage. That's a tough cookie.
Mission
running out of ammunition soon, so... We'll drop our missiles there and... So we need to return south to rearm and repair. Our fighter is like a half damage. Even the newer Ace Combats have this kind of missions where you can rearm, but not too many. We can actually change the weapons, but we are okay with this. Back to the fight.
Thank you. Enemy planes are coming at us.
Belkan fighters. Great. Perfect timing.
Alright, so we are okay. That was enough. We mopped up the whole place basically.
Did something just flash?
Yeah, there's like couple these kind of missions where you just blow off stuff. That's the best way to describe these kind of missions. Blow up a lot of stuff, rearm, blow up more stuff. And even the latest Ace Combat games have these kind of cool looking outside views of the planes, so you can actually see what you were doing in the game.
Operation was a success. Gladysant has fallen. The Allied forces have broken through the Hydrian line, bringing the battle to Belka. I must inform you, however, that while you were on your mission, you received a report that the squadron attacking from Ustio's border was wiped out by a mysterious attack. We are currently investigating this incident.
Mysterious attack, so more super weapons. I think that's pretty nice. So we are the soldier. Just in the middle of the morality scale, which is how I have planned to play this playthrough.
Belka's second line of defense stretches across the Shane Plains in the central region of southern Belka. Centered on two anti-aircraft camps, this line blocks our refueling unit's air route. It is already delaying our military plans. This operation will consist of attacks on enemy ground troops and engagements with enemy fighters. There will be three squadrons in total. You can decide which one to accompany.
Okay.
Alpha Team will be responsible for destroying enemy ground ordnance. Beta Team's job will be to eliminate air resistance and destroying enemy ground ordnance. Theta Team will eliminate air resistance. Escort Allied transport craft after each mission is completed. That is all.
So I suppose I'm going to take the Theta team. In the first playthrough, I took the I think it was Alpha team. So Theta team is air-to-air battle basically from start to finish. And I had. Let's see what we can buy. So if you start, there's like basic fighters for you at the start, but then you can get even more interesting fighters. And the fact is that you unlock these possibility to buy these fighters through playing different morality levels. So soldier gets different picks than knight, for example. Look at this, is a four-seater. even prototype fighters. Yeah, this is the Japanese version of the F-16. A Strike Eagle. And we can get the jamming version of the Hornet. Rafale. This is pretty advanced fighter in this game. Strike Flanker. EAF-23A Black Widow. Very advanced fighter. Yeah. Raptor might be fun, but we have basically something we can use already. And that's from my last game. It's Suhoi 37 Terminator, which is... This is pretty crazy fighter. Thank for following. 4-4. G Katusha. If I manage to butcher the name. First general tank.
Belkan fighters approaching. Shoot them down and secure air superiority.
No one's gonna be easy today. We're all in an equal share. I just got a feeling.
This is gonna be one hell of a fight.
It's the mighty Usio mercenaries. Let's watch how they fight.
Locked on.
And we are doing some war crimes today because I want to keep my morality scale in the middle in this game. Okay, these are top fighters. I had this game on for PS2 and then somebody stole it. Oh no.
Bandits in gun range.
Good thing you can now play many games with the emulators. Ah, missed. How did the second one? Let's use guns. Some people think this is the best of the Ace Combat games. I tend to think that I think I like the fifth Ace Combat best, Unsung War. Strangereal, yeah. I suppose I'm going to stream the Ace Combat 4 as well. It's very... The first game that was set in the Strangereal.
Thank you.
Let's not collide with the wounded fighter. Electro Spear. Yeah, I don't count the first Ace Combat games because the fact is that they are kind of retconned. I'm kind of waiting for the developers to make a new versions of the first because they were basically sci-fi. Because there's small hints in this game that there's like the plot has been changing. Like Nagase, she was a commercial pilot in Ace Combat 4, and then she ends up flying the fighters in 5. I mean, yeah, sure, could happen.
All enemy fighters have been eliminated. Threat level reduced to 2.
I think this might be the best fighter in this game. What do you think? What's the best fighter in Ace Combat Zero? That's a sci-fi. Yeah, number 3 was Revenant in the original type version, the best one. Yeah, definitely groundbreaking even. So now we need to escort these fighters. Yeah, we can't escort them from that. Okay, and let's not take too much speed.
Incoming emergency message from Operations HQ. Enemy launching long range attacks. Current airspace is within range.
Now you tell us. Where should we fly?
Yeah, those ADFs. Zero one and zero two. Yeah, sure. Now I'm going to focus. Yeah, those red dots appear. So I can't go with the 1000 knots because I'm going to fly into the red explosives here. Yep. Apparently it helps if I fly low. Smaller in the lower altitude. Exop snow. Okay. Oops. Oops. And of course they are shooting. Those Belkans. Halfway there. Oh no. That was pretty close. About to say the thing's name, yeah. I have very poor memory of names. I think they are starting to shoot more barrage in this mission towards the end. Yeah. Okay, if I can. Okay, that's it. Galm is a mythological being that is guardian of hell, other known as.
Return to base.
Yeah, I think it is. Yeah, lots of mythological names in this game from different cultures.
That was a bad nightmare. We lost several of our members.
We are being going to eat. Yeah, that's a good hobby for big mortals.
We survived.
Pixies just driving. Well, he shot couple guys down, so shouldn't complain too much.
Achieved, but our forces were dealt a heavy blow by enemy laser ordnance. Our country must put an end to this war. If not, I fear the war will put an end to us.
Okay, I need to shoot more